I had a friend who, and we talked about this a little bit. I had a friend who was struggling with water retention around her period. And I had been very exposed to a lot of stuff about progesterone being the good hormone and estrogen being the bad hormone.
Oh yeah.
I looked at a really good paper that showed that in women who had water retention symptoms with PMS, the main difference in their hormones was that they weren't clearing progesterone as fast mm-hmm. from their ovulation-related peak. Mm-hmm. And I was discussing this with a different friend who had found that she would consistently get water retention in response to using progesterone creams. Mm-hmm. And so there were a couple things that were kind of all making me a little more pro-estrogen than I had been in the past, like leading yeah. up to listening to that podcast. I'm still left a little confused though. If estrogen is protective against age-related dementia, why does most Alzheimer's happen in women? Like the three big risk factors.
For isn't it because we're like a big reason, right? That we are protected up to the point and then we go through menopause and we lose all that estrogen. So, a man's production of estrogen and a postmenopausal woman's production of estrogen. I mean, it's really interesting to look at.
Oh, I wonder if I'm so uneducated about this that I don't know if my speculation does more good than harm, but I wonder if it's related to the change in hormones because so the female brain talks a lot about estrogen's influence on just modifying the synaptic density of various parts of the brain and that changing in after menopause. But maybe men are protected because they aren't placed with the demand of completely rewiring their brain after they've set it up for 50 years.
Right. Right. Because men go through puberty and while there are changes and declines, women go through puberty and then, you know, often there's pregnancies. So it's all these spikes. And then we go through reverse puberty when we go through perimenopause yeah. into menopause. And cognitive symptoms are so big, so common from my perimenopausal women who say, I used to remember everything. And now I can't remember anything. I have to write lists. I feel like I have dementia. I have incredible brain fog. I read something and I can't remember it. I can't listen to podcasts anymore because I don't remember what they're saying or I can't really comprehend it. I get this all the time from women as they hit their 40s and into their 50s as their estrogen is going up and down, but eventually, of course, declines with menopause. So, and it's not often, at least with my patient population, a gradual thing. It's not like for the last, 15 years, women will say, I'm having to write lists more and more. It's usually, what the heck, for my 45th birthday, I can't sleep and I can't remember anything. I'm yeah. like, and I gained 15 pounds. I'm like, yeah. Whoever designed menopause can suck it. It's so not fair. And, biologically, we live a really long time and we weren't designed to. So women, we had all this estrogen up to a point and then we don't. And then we go into menopause and we have very little levels, very low levels. In fact, a man's estrogen and a postmenopausal woman's estrogen are about on par if you look at the reference ranges. But he doesn't go through all the up-down yeah. stuff. And he doesn't have high levels, through a lot of his cycle. And he doesn't get pregnant. And so he doesn't have all this excessive normal estrogen stuff thrown his way and thrown his brain's way. And then it all gets taken away. I mean, it's gone. Sorry. Can't have it.